And welcome everyone, I am back. We have, as you can expect, as I promised, the Martel versus Martel matchup. Interestingly enough, it's not Worlds to Come versus Worlds to Come. We have Martel Assault from the Shadow on the side of Ilno. On the side of Singapore, and Dave is playing his Worlds to Come deck that we've seen so much at this point. Quickly, while the game is starting, no, oh. I hate this. Oh, don't click anywhere until the game starts. So Martel Shadows, I will go. Dave asked for a moment, so he will. Both players chose a legal for the World Cup decks. And we are up. So, Assault from the Shadows, we have a Prince Doran Behest, Double Mar, Dulheris, Morghulis, Riddle, You Win or You Die. Cards that could be working in Shadow is Doran's Game, of course. We have Dorn, Dornish Fiefdoms, Gaston Grey 3 times, Summer Seaport and Rose Road. All of these are 3 times. 3 times Condemned for the attachments. And character base, we have Corset, Ariel Hota, Shadows, Ariane Martel, Bastard Daughter, Desert Raider, Dornish Spy. All these are 3 of. 2 times Old Bill Bone. One copy of Sir Archibald Ironwood. After you lose a dominant, the winning component must choose and kill a character he or she controls. Sergeri's Drinkwater, of course. And then Shadow City Buster, Southern Escort, Southern Messenger, Starfall Spy, and Varys from Daggers in the Dark, the kill Varys. I haven't seen the deck how this plays, I have no idea what to expect. No, there is a timer. So the timer starts after the mulligan, Dave. After the setup. Oh, yep, there is the timer. And regarding Dave's deck, we have 2 times City Besiege, which is an interesting approach. At Prince Doran Behest, at the gates. Manning the City Walls, March, First Snow of Winter. Dulheris, Morghulis and Varys Riddle. So the plot decks are like 80% the same. There is no You Win or You Die in the only difference that's not in the World to Come deck. Everything else is in part of the World to Come deck. And vice versa. Restricted cards for both players, we already mentioned Doran's Game. Dave increased the number of Ecology thinking he's usually playing. Before it was only one, now we see two. But interestingly enough, there is only one Princess Plans, and all that is in favor of Iron Bank of Heavy's Duel, Hand's Judgment, and 2 copies of Secret Schemes. And we have 2 times Venomous Blade. I feel like this will be not that useful in the current matchup, although you don't want the Desert Raiders dead, you want them in the discard pile. So. That's what this. So looks like one of the players will get Riddle the opponents at the gates. And this will be it. The other at the gates will be not riddled. And we already see we are 3 pots in for Dave. Somehow. I mean, it makes sense for him to run the Riddle early. He doesn't want to Riddle Marches or Morghulis or Dulheris. Nothing of that. It's to his benefit. So that makes sense. Yep. His list is pretty standard for the mining of City Walls. We have 3 times Host of the Boneway. and 3 times Knights of the Sun. Everything else, there is no the draw. I don't see the draw army. Just because I cannot remember the name, I'm going to go through all of them. But yeah, there is no. There is not that army. Yep. Now he just has to find his Ricasso and load him up. We see a Gaston. Rivergate, Dorn. And I assume that Dorn was reduced by 2. So yeah. Let's see, with Water Gardens on the board, that makes it great. A economy speed boost here. Let's see, a card move to Shadows. Both players have Dorn, so a lot of triggers to be expected here. Shadow City Buster. Little bit sleepy. You should see me yawing. So, what are the cool interactions that the Martell suit from the Shadows has aside from Condemned and Gaston out of nowhere? Archibald is an interesting choice. But other than that, you could put. Oh no, they're not even in the deck. The House Dane Escorts are not in the deck, so you can put them in Shadow, discard them for the Southhorn Escorts, so they get out of Shadow free and then have them. This deck, the Assault from the Shadow suffers a lot from the banning of Flea Bottom. So yeah. Yeah, and all those cards come with the price of Warfare. Oof! That's a very hefty discard in the face of Cost of the Bonway. Although both decks are running both resets, so we'll see a lot of removal of characters. And looks like this will be for the challenges phase. And Dominant goes to Dave. So it looks like the Martell player didn't decide not to give card to the other Martell player. I assume we're gonna see at the gates here for Assault player. No one saw that, don't worry. We really didn't see it. No. Oh, no, let me just get the player name because it will get weird. So, Edison. Edison and Dave. Repeat it 10 times to remember it, my chicken brain. We see Duhiris into March. Makes sense. I mean, use all resets that you don't need to. The Haldane escort gonna get marched. I'm curious to see why the march here. What is so scary on this board? Considering there is a Haldane escort, the march doesn't make any sense. Dave is used to playing in Starek where the timer starts like when they announce it, when you get to the board to your table, that's a completely different thing. Water Gardens for 3. I'm playing Secret Schemes to draw 3. That feels like a wasted Water Gardens for some reason. I mean, you would like to use it for something more big, but consider Dorn is on the board, not targets on the other side, there's actually probably nothing big enough for any type of shenanigans here. Not one but two Haldane escorts. You can march away as much as you want. Those won't go away. And to see a Dornish Freedom trigger from Madison. No surprising seeing that. Assault from the shadows to put a card in shadow. Most of the Martell cards don't have shadow keyword, there's like two native ones and that's it. Interestingly enough that in the Martell, the Assault from the Shadows, aside from the 3 times hand judgment that of your playing Assault from the Shadows basically for that, unless you are Targaryen, there they don't help. You have way too many events that you wanna play. But we have, we don't see the Martell event that removes icons. Even that didn't make the cut into Assault from the Shadows where it could be for free, for one. So imagine how terrible that card is. And the staff of pilot direct to Marshall to see military for 4. Trying to kill that staff of spy, else they just go endlessly into challenges. Interesting enough, with all this jumping of characters in and out of shadows, surprisingly, I would have probably considered running Hota's axe. So yeah, if you find Dario Hota, so at least he's going to defend the challenge now. To bring some tempo advantage, strength buffs. Well, the Starfall Spies are amazing with Hota Axe. And considering they are the engine of your deck. We see Dawn Trigger for Dave. We see a power challenge. So there was no point for keeping both of the Audien escorts just because the Starforce Pike can just push the Intercade and do whatever else it wants. And we're gonna see if there is his Viper Vice. And we see that one copy of Fiend Judgment proving very useful here. On the post power. Fortunately, no power on the opponent's house. This will be a very long game, I feel like. That's why at the beginning, Dave was worried about the timer. And no one with dominoes. Interesting, we didn't see a challenge with the Southbound Escorts. So is there a consideration for Morgulis here? That feels like a little bit of stretch considering you're running 3 times Ariel Hota. So you need him off the board, so probably a second march. And we see how the next card discarded for reserve. And we see this time march into Duharis. Although I feel like this is helping the Shadow Spear just because we're going to remove Ariel from the board. And we see how Daniel's Fort marched. Both players are doing minimal number of challenges, so they don't give fuel to their opponent. Obviously no one wants to Morgulis, considering the Desert Raiders on one side of the board. Although, I mean, they would be happy with Morgulis, but he doesn't probably want to use his. So, what's that are left for the Shadows player is Morgulis, you win or you die. And another march. Okay, yeah. So, march, you win or you die, and Morgulis. And for Dave, quite a bit more. So, double besieged at the gates. Oh no, Dave used his at the gate given. So he has Manning, First Snow of Winter, Morgulis, and Double Besieged. So a lot of claiming coming, basically. You see Shadow Sleep Bastard joining the fray. Dave collects 6 gold. Overall, a stable economy. I have a feeling it's time for a Venomous Blade. Considering it's basically free this time. But the opponent almost didn't give any extra triggers for the Dorn, so aside from winning one military on defense, which felt like unnecessary. I'm curious how this deck is pushing the Intrigue by 5. There is not that many Intrigues in the deck. I mean, there is enough, but not that many. We see Sir Cletus and Quentin. So now there is pressure. So from the word from Dave. So a chump intrigue challenge. I feel like this should be defended probably, or maybe not. Depends what's on in the hand, or if you really really want that Dorn trigger. Now the current board is definitely one that you would consider Morguling if you are at the site of the Assault from the Shadows. We see Gaston trigger on the Shadow City Bastard, so Dave will not have any of that. Let's see what our Garden discarded at random. Looks like that would be for his challenges. He has a straight military. I wonder if it will be with more than one challenge for this one. No, just one. Not enough gold for Ario. Oh. Okay, this helps. But again, you're giving your opponent a trigger. We see Sir Gary's Drinkwater discarded from Shadow, that's not something you would like to see. And we have a Dorn trigger. Dave is playing Corset Ariel as well, not the claim raising one. An intrigue challenge for 3. I'm not exactly sure why the Darkhold Spy is so heavily defended. I'm not sure there is that much value to that character, I would say. The Dorn trigger. And Mercy pod discarded. So I wonder if you're gonna see Condemned now. But not so deep, you're gonna get his Renown and Quentin. And Dominant got today, so 5-0. He decided not to get renowned, so looks like his renown is turned off. Just because of that Varys working in shadows. And we see Sir Geralt Drinkwater discarded, looks like he thinks he doesn't need it. Sorry about that. So we see another march into City Besieged. As mentioned, cheeky Dave needing his own Dorne instead of opponent's Dorne. We see another Gaston joining the fray, Rian Martell. All good things you would love to see. Finally the Star Wars spy was marched, interesting. After so much protection, and we see finally see the desert traded from the side of the Assault in the Shadows player. And challenges phase. So currently no gold on both sides, so let's see how this will go. But that to claim is pretty scary, I would say. So with Arian and Kratos, or just okay, so challenge only with Arian. Looks like here the goal will be to nuke the hand. In position 4-4 Dorn trigger. And we see Dorn's game discarded. And another south for the escort. We hear the case that the Doran's game is gone. The first one. Dave looks like he's struggling to find his one copy of Picasso. The power challenge. Power challenge. I wonder if Dave will be tempted to gain renown at some point. Currently it's not that beneficial for him, just because he's giving targets for Varys, but there are not that many cards in Shadow currently to be worried about Varys. Unfortunately no power on the opponent's action card. Yep, and he's starting game taking renown. He decided that there is no time for wait. And that will be it. I don't expect to see any challenges from the Assault on the Shadows player. So plots that are left for him is Morghulis and you win or you die. This feels very bad to be at the Assault on the Shadows player, so you don't want a Morghulis, although the board is pretty in a pretty interesting position. We see Dark Star switch for Arianne. In dominance, he is a lot more expendable than the Arianne, of course, and it's just a single copy in the deck. Yep. Now the question is, do you Morghulis here or you play you win or you die? Your hand is pretty big to go you win or you die. Also, I feel like we see Manning. With Sir Clitus securing the initiative, the Morghulis is going to go first, Dave is going to be first player, and we're going to see a big army probably drop down with all the intimidate in the world. Yep. There in the assault list, I believe there are Dorne Spice. Everything is spicy here, so. There is a chance for the army to be controlled, but Dave is turning one copy of the printed spawns. That will probably be more than enough if he has both of those cards in hand. Secure a stable position. And to ask what is you win or you die, not something that you would like to do. Going into recycling, but this is Starfall, joining the fray for free. As always, very steady and methodical game from Dave. There is at least one South Cornish score. All three are in the discard pile, so there is more than enough characters for Dave to run by. And see Dornish with them new. For another Dornish Kingdom, is there a bank plate? No. Did I miss something? Ah, because Soul from the Shadows is minus one gold, of course. Card goes to Shadow, 4 gold save this time around, so a lot more gold. I don't expect any actions from Dave. Oh, let's see, will there be an action from the Martel side? Looks like no. So, big military challenge with both characters. Military intrigue challenges with both characters, just because Hota can ruin your day, but then you don't have enough gold for the you don't have enough gold for Doran's game into Monopole. So this is definitely Doran's game, Princess Plants into Doran's game. Get the strength, bro. The strength pump. Doran's game for 6. That will go directly to 13. Hand judgment, hand judgment, hand judgment. Wait, how many? Yep. Yep, so that is, I think this is all the hand judgment. No, there is one more in the deck. Dorn trigger. Yep. That's why you use this agenda precisely only for the hand judgments. Play all of them. And Dorn game discarded for claim. That's fair. That feels fair. But from here on. Imagine if there was a Rian on the board for removing all the icons. Unfortunately for the Martel player, there is still time. Dave can probably find his more than one already in the hand, considering he secret schemes for 6 cards in this phase, this turn. See Rian for Knight of the Sun, another renowned body. What Varys's cost again? I always forget. So 8, definitely not enough for each other. So we see Chaos the Bastard ambushed, so this is probably going to stop Knights of the Sun from challenge. Starfold remove the power icon or the intrigue icon. Okay. And Dominant goes to Dave, that is 9. We are going to see probably another manning, another city besiege from Dave. Unfortunately, that's not going to win him initiative. But he's gonna kill the reserve at the gain on opponent side. So it will be you win or you die. Is there a high enough initiative for to be you win, to beat you win or you die here? First no, maybe. First no could be a very interesting choice, although those have ambush, but that will tax the economy even more. I think besiege will be the play from Dave. Edison has to decide who is going to be first. I expected Dave to be first, so looks like he has enough counters to stop the big entry challenge, although I don't feel like that move. That doesn't seem like reasonable enough. If I'm both on the side of Dave, I don't expect to see a lot of marshalling. Just keep your resources for the shenanigans if he has drawn them. That looks like just one gold is more than enough. And Venomous Blade takes care of the Shadow City Bastard. Then getting Karian with enough strength. So both of them threaten the remove from the game shenanigans. The Doran's game. And Doran's game at this stage is winning the game. We see another card in put into shadows. Unfortunately, not enough gold to remove all the intrigue items and have still have Hota. The city besiege proved to be very key here. You need the other one. Condemned doesn't help that much. You don't have any power, so... And Shadow Speed battered by the dust, so time for some actions now. And he calls it thinkings as well. Looks like no. Inter challenge with Bolt immediately. So going to return Arian to the hand. And now what? Interesting that there is no Iron Bank to have his view in the Shadows list. I feel like it should be there. I feel like it should also have in Prince Doran's name. Was it Prince Doran's name? What was the card? That gives gold to any new your faction card, but you cannot use it with the agenda actually, so. Maybe skip it one time. Let's see, another post challenge. Doran's game. Of course. And then judgment. Of course. So this is the second Doran's game that got cancelled. And third hand judgment removed. You see Desert Trader giving power. And removing power icon. And the other Desert Trader. And we see discarded Starfall Spy and Contempt. And the Desert got intimidated. We're gonna see a military challenge. There is one more Desert Trader that could come and prove. Very annoying. But he cannot gain a military icon which Starfall will take care of, so the board will be preserved. And those two will be removed from the game, or will be given for playing. That is. It's coming around all Southern Court. Still not enough, feel like. But looks like the DF is going to remove the military icon regardless. Yeah, but then the other Desert Trader is going to come around. But it looks like DF just cares for the unopposed. He is well aware what is going to happen. Card draw from Dorm. He quickly choosing the cards from Edison. Giving another power to the Desert Trader, getting the power icon. Almost 90% sure that Gaston Grey will return the Desert Trader to hand. There is one less on the board. It's coming to Dave's Morghulis turn. So Dave has first snow left and Morghulis. I don't feel like he needs his Morghulis, so the first snow is more than enough, although his board is gonna get wiped here. But giving him two cards won't be that bad. Or maybe he can Iron Bank something to the hand. Like the army and then ambush, something to stop the power challenge at least. Or the military challenge. It's only one copy though, so. As mentioned, military challenge. Oh, but there will be two desert raiders coming down, so they'll take the claim. Both of them, I assume. So, and take the power and intrigue icon. Okay, there is still hope here. Or he's just gonna do Iron Bank shenanigans. I assume he doesn't wanna give his opponents remove the data tree from the challenge, but then what are you going to do about the power challenge then, Dave? Is definitely going to come. I feel like the other one was probably better. Because now you're definitely losing power challenge. But if he wants to do the power challenge, which is actually mandatory, then he's losing the Southbound Escort. Then we are definitely going to see for snow next turn. Now with army in the hand, there is more than enough economy for that army to play. It also gives you the initiative probably. Also the Hota protect from March, unless you want to riddle the March of course, but I don't see that happening ever. Oh no, you can't, you're still... Okay, so first node, definitely first node next turn. The question is what is going to be on the... Oh, probably Morgulis. Just to remove the 3 power from the escort. Dorn, Gaston. The escort to hand. Although he'll be able to keep one card. So. Maybe that escort is gonna be kept, but then this way you're forcing his hand to keep exactly that one escort. Yep, see Gaston. Unfortunately, there is no way to protect the army from Morgulis this turn. Sorry. You have more than enough resources in your discard pile on the site of the Haldane escort are there still. Although they'll be pretty dead on a personal turn. If you wanna try and protect this, else he could just fire his Morgulis. If he's expecting the opponent to Morgulis here. Grimbo Trader discarded. Not what you want to see. And let's see, the Southhorn Escort stayed in hand. Yep. But unfortunately there is one to... two condemns discarded. So Dave snap picked his spot, so he knows what... he has a clear idea what his plan is. Yeah, for snow into Behest, which will probably flip Morgulis. He'll probably make the Martell player, the Shadow player first. Cut down his economy a little bit. Also, he chose to go first, so. Yep, Morgulis. We know there is House Danish court in the hand. A Southhorn messenger. Death is back to 10, so 1, 2. I expect to see a big army. And that will probably be it. Oh no, Orion. Just because Venomous Blade can be ambushed, yep. Give the extra 5 the 1 power for the last Doran's game. But if there is Condemned in Shadow, this pawn is doomed as well. An agenda trigger. There is no Warhand Judgment, right? 3 Hand Judgments are played. See a personal trigger and let's see now what will how the challenge phase will go here. Trying to see power challenge from Dave. That confuses me a little bit. I don't know what 5 costs. We have Dorne Spy. Why? I mean, really, really why? Remove the power icon and then. But that's 4 then. You're a gold short. Right. I'm looking for the cell phone messenger. Yeah, oh, it's even 5. What was the point here? I'm confused. Okay, so this giving back the power icon and Brazilian strength. So it was in shadows, not from the. Okay, yeah, that makes sense then. Correct sequencing from Dave. We're going to remove the power icon now. We see an above challenge. I completely bunked on the option that this could be in shadow because I know there is one in hand and I was counting 5 gold, so this in shadow makes a lot more sense. Removing the icon again, giving power, card draw. Unfortunately, there is no claim, so James coming to see the finale. One more. Oh. Why is the board present necessary here? I mean, yeah, Ariant is going probably to jump. He's preventing this way the unopposed trick. He knows that last plot is Morghulis, so this one the board is going to go away. Let's see, Ariant Martel. Dornish by removing his power icon. We're gonna see an intrigue. And looks like this will be it. I don't expect to see any challenges from the assault on the Shadow Flare, because it's basically going to give cards. You're on a zero claim. Why are you doing this? So. Rivergate. You could trigger Dave's Rivergate, also doesn't sound like a good idea. Monopose, Dorm, Flame. Mm-hmm. And this Flint is fast back. All bad things in my eyes. All terrible things just happened. Are we gonna see an ambushing of Venomous Blade? Just to keep down the hand size forward. Going to kill that escort. Because he could be. I mean, what? Dave, don't you have Morghulis? Yep, there is Morghulis coming, so Cluster Dominance. Yep. Oh, this gives you Dominance. That's why he killed it. Okay, makes sense. Now this makes more sense. I mean, Dave is smarter than me, obviously. And Morghulis. I wonder what the play will be from the Assault from the Shadows player. Probably you win or you die again. Try to steal a little bit of power. Although with the... So let's see how many resources are expended actually. 2 Southern Escorts, 2 Southern Messengers. All Southern Escorts are Gonaks actually. And one copy of Southern Messenger is gone. And we know one is in the hand. So... A riddle into Morghulis? How does the riddle help here? I would probably definitely consider to win or you die. Because it's going to give you all the additional resources that you need. Rian again. Unfortunately now the Outer Gardens is dead. Although it proved very useful for the whole game up until now. So there is no Renown left in the deck. We have Quentin is dead. Too early for Knights of the Sun, but that will be fixed with the next plot behest probably. And hopefully this will be it. Just enough gold for everything. Although yeah, I was looking at the gain gold. The Dornish freedom. And the third Desert Trader Marshal. Our challenge. Same dance as before. Turn inspire removing an icon of a choice. I think Dave is gonna give it back, definitely. No? I wonder why he decided not to... Oh, he called it thinking. Okay, so to waste the money of his opponent. I mean... Trigger Starfall to remove the power icon. He's gonna get that valuable on a post. Yeah, he finally drew one. Looks like all southern escorts were in the discard pile, in the shadow area. Viper's Eyes. And let's see. Is there a Doran's game? Although it doesn't matter at this stage. I think Dave is just gonna power through the power challenge with Rian. Oh, Venomous Blade removed. Okay. Interesting enough, there is nothing more impactful. That seems weird. Oh! Now we see Begging Bros. With Pistol for 2. And he's going for the intro challenge. Just to waste resources. Doesn't that mean you're gonna get power challenge back? But you're gonna get power, so that's... He cannot trigger the desert raiders now when he's supporting that person. Won the challenge, gave his opponent a card. But this... depending on the order of challenges, there is only one Iron Bank in the deck actually. Or, yeah, there is only one today. That will be it. Military challenge to be left on the pause. Trigger one of the desert raiders to stop the intrigue. So Doran. Trader of Deserts. Move on, I remove the intrigue. Yep. Not enough for dominance, unfortunately. Oh, he can get the other one. Get the other one. And this gives dominance. Wait! Kill the Begging Bro. Oh. No, why didn't he kill the Begging Brother in one dominance? Did I miss something? Dave, you missed little. Missed little. I wonder if his teammates are screaming inside. Although he is quite far ahead, but the game is far from over. That thing is for sure. How many Doran games we've seen from his opponent? So they're 3 in the discard pile, so Dave has at least one left. March to the wall into a Prince Doran's behest. Naturally, this is gonna be first player. Wait, he was made first player? Why? So, behest. Riddle doesn't make sense. Here is Morgulis. So the Desert Trader is March. Yep, at the gates. Clean out the deck, remove everything unnecessary from there. And I somehow thought that Dave's gonna finish a quick game. Ugh. Now we are here for 2 to 3 more turns. We know there is a Rian in hand with the Princess Pawns. Oh, that's gonna give infinite strength. Gold from fiefdoms. Water Garden for 2. That's going probably to reduce a Dornish fiefdom. I'll do this and open the messages when I think we see a big army, we see a Rian, and I'm gold. It should be Edison's Marshalling, Cap and Shadow. So one South Corner Sport is on the board. None in the discard pile. Gains in gold. And one is in the death pile. So there is only one more Southcorn Escort. Southcorn Messenger. Escorts are all done. All gone. What of possible shenanigans? I mean, check when we go into challenges. Still not. So are you guys enjoying the game? The few people watching. Native shadow card. Look at that. Is Aru alive or dead? Aru is alive. So we could see condemned. Although the begging water will probably stop most of the shenanigans. So the native Shadow Steel Buster, did they hit Shadow? No, they are ambushed. So, look like it's Star Post Pi or Varys. Intrigue challenge, I assume. Oh, it's a military. Okay, military challenge. We see Rian coming out of Shadows. Going to remove one icon, gonna get cancelled probably. Unfortunately, it looks like I'm gonna need this. I wonder which icon she's targeting. One gold cancelled. Position for 3, and there is 3 for intimidate, so the South Corner Escort gonna get intimidated. Oh, but now the Desert Raider cannot be triggered. What am I talking about? So no Desert Raider triggers. I'm gonna see intimidate somewhere. So the yeah, platform is probably gonna get intimidated. And this is power challenge with bolt. Okay. Yeah, because Hota, but Hota is 3 gold. Removing Star Hall Spy. Just to make sure we see a Salt on Escort. That is not enough. Going to pause and pick one. Hey! I mean, 10 to the hour and a half, so remove an icon there. I don't see how this helps. It's gonna, yeah, it's gonna affect this autonomous card. Yep. Mm-hmm. Position for 2. And that's game. Yep, Desert Trader for the game. Okay. Took us an extra turn, but we got there. General solid showing from Dave, who is, we all know, a Martell loyalist. So yep, so this will be for now, guys. I'll jump offline for some time. I have to play my game. And then we're gonna have an interview with James. With Dave. With Dave. So we're gonna see his beautiful face. After my game. In around 8 o'clock. The interview is scheduled for around 8 o'clock. So the calls are there will be a probably, if you are subscribed, of course there will be a notification. Thank you everyone for joining and see you tonight.